What's up, everybody? I am BK, BKBangers.com. Welcome to another episode of Sample School Sundays, episode 10. Today, I kind of, you know, I'm doing this little test out of another software to do the recording process. And hopefully it comes out and translates well because ScreenFlow be acting up crazy. A lot of gigs. I don't want to, you know, edit so much. There's a lot of editing that goes on behind the scenes of all of this. So basically, testing out some new works. This sample of today comes from King James. I Still Love You. King James, I Still Love You. Released 1974. It's a funk soul. You know, so we're gonna keep it funky and soul-ish today. Alright, so I have the sample already tuned. I know the BPM that I'm working with. I'm just not sure if I'm gonna go double time or I'm gonna, you know, play it in single time. I don't have the drums yet, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play with the chops because I already, you know, kind of have the chops ready. So I'm gonna play with the chops, come up with a pattern, and then look for the drums. Alright, so sit back, get some popcorn, some juice. It's Sunday, the games is on. I'm not quite sure who's playing today, but whoever's playing, hopefully they win. Post a comment down below, let me know what team you're going for. Are you going for LeBron or you going for Curry? Because we all know that's who's making it to the finals this year. If you don't know, now you know. Better believe. And then this track is called King James. I'm gonna name this one King James too, but I might not. We'll see. But yeah, so I'm gonna go over here to the MP and play around till I get something. All right, BKBangers.com. I think I got something that we could play with it and see what we come up with. Alright, so I'm gonna lay that down real quick. Alright, so the tempo was originally 57 BPMs and I tuned it and I kind of pushed it back up to double time. I don't know if times 57 times 2 is 114, so the BPM is currently now 114 BPMs, but it's still not supposed to be playing like that. I'm not sure. Let me change the time signature to the 1/16th rather than 1/8th. Let's see if that makes a difference. Nah, buddy. Wherever I go, he go, nobody. Alright, let me see something. Let me see if I paint this shit in. What happened? Matter of fact, let's see something. I think it's 30 seconds. 30, second notes. That shit is way off. All right. Let's delete that. Let's delete that real quick. And on a rare occasion, I'm gonna start off with some drums. I'm gonna go to these instruments. I'm not gonna play with the MPC today. I'm gonna play with the MPK Mini, and I'm gonna do so. I'm gonna get my drums loaded up in sample one. Right now, I'm gonna load about kick, snare. Where'd that third one go? Sample one, two. This thing be bugging out sometimes. Hold up. Sometimes sample, when you drag and drop the instrument, it'll drop on top of the instrument before it, and it'll cancel out the routing. So when it gets to the mix console, there will be no fader for it. So like I was saying, kick, snare, a hi-hat, a closed hi-hat, an open hi-hat, some form of percussion. You see, like, it just did it just now. So shout out to Sound Oracle. Man, the Inferno drums, bro. That's all I really been messing with these last couple of days ever since I got the kit. It's like, it's dope, man. And it's a free kit. If you purchase the Oracle percussion loops, you get the Inferno drums. I think that sale ends, today's Sunday, so that sale ended, I think, Friday. So, yeah. But if you can, go out there and go support the homie. The kid is fire. Believe when I tell you, the kid is fire. Alright, so hold on. Oh, you know what I did? Oh, shit. I deleted the fucking... Oh, my goodness. Excuse my language. I'm gonna have to do this all over again. Uh-oh. Damn, son. I have to do this all over again. Never could get this thing to go just straight up without me having to do it 10 times over. So we got the sample preloaded. I'ma do 87 BPMs. 87. Time. One, two, three. Load 6 instances of sample 1, and I'm gonna load up my drums like I said before, but I had to go back and, you know, fix shit, 'cause that's what we do. We fix shit. Nah. Kick will work. Hold on, let me check though. I think that one will work. Alright, so this is the kick. Kick. Go to this one, load up a snare. Make sure y'all save y'all stuff. See if this snare works. All right, that's gonna work. All right, so I got the kick and the snare. I'm gonna come off of this, so now it just plays out what I want. I'm gonna set a loop up, a loop excuse me, I'm gonna set a loop mark. Where's bring this back to the beginning. I'm gonna lay the snare down first. Oh, I missed my count. 1, 2, 3, go. So you said a 3 beat. All right, so now I'm gonna lay the kick down. Leave it on 16 notes. I got this basic beat going. I'm gonna go ahead now and I'm gonna mess with these chops to see what I come up with. Thank you. Oracle drums is crazy, man. Alright, so what I'm gonna do now, I'm gonna keep this for whatever reason. I might go back to it. And I'm gonna extend this out to 8 bars. How long I've been recording for? I've been recording for way too long. Sometimes I start this thing and I'm like, yo, I'm gonna just knock it out. Then, you know, we run into technical difficulties and all that. So, you know, thank y'all so much for stopping by. It's your boy BK, BK Bangers, BKBangers.com. If you haven't already subscribed, this is a perfect time to do so. If you like this content, if there's anything in this episode that you mess with, you know what I'm saying, and you learning something, post a comment down below. Let me know what it is. Share the series with your, you know, your fellow YouTuber, your friend, your girlfriend, you know, your brother, your uncle, whoever. You know, it helps the channel out a ton when you guys share. And I do understand that not everybody who views any video on YouTube actually have a subscription, or not a subscription, but have a channel of their own, if that makes any sense. I believe that's how you should say it. If you have your own channel, then you're able to subscribe to other people's channel. But if you don't have an account, if you have an account, a YouTube account, or even a Gmail, if you have a Gmail account, then you could get a YouTube account, simple like that. But not everybody have YouTube or Gmail. They just go on YouTube from their mobile devices and they type in YouTube, and whatever comes up on YouTube, they just watch it. They don't have any account. So for you guys that don't have any account, thank you so much for just viewing and watching. And for those of you who are returning subscribers, I thank you for your subscription. And for you, I'm talking to you, yes, you, hit that subscribe button right now. And when that Liberty Bell opens up, be sure to hit the Liberty Bell so you become at liberty to be notified anytime we upload any new content on the channel. All right, I am BK, BKBangers.com. This is Sample School Sunday, episode 11. I believe it's 11. I be doing so many of these things that I be forgetting where we at. All right, so now I extended the loop section. You see, make sure when, if you're in Studio One and you come from the MPC world, whenever we put a loop, the loop mark is usually 8 or 16 or 2, 2, 4, 6, 8, you know, it goes by 2. But in Studio One, in order for it to be an 8-bar loop, you have to extend the loop marker to 9. And sometimes I'll be, you know, I said I'm gonna make an 8-bar loop and I'll drop it on 8, because in the MPC, I usually just drop it on 8 and I'm Gucci, but small thing. So I'm gonna play around again until I come up with something. I kinda had it just now, but all that talking threw me off. This is why I don't be talking. Take off this.
Bye.
Something like that, you know what I mean? Something like, nothing too crazy. I think I got something. Sugarfoot. Sugarfoot and plum. So. So we got a second part that could possibly be the hook or the verse. We're not sure at this current point. We're just in creation mode. So I'm gonna play it back from the top. That was smooth, but I'm going to make another selection just because. Let me see what it's gonna sound like. Hold up, I think I got something. Come on. So it's getting better with the chops as we go along, but at this point I'm thinking in my head, like, do I want to put an EQ on the sample and get all those bottom, because there's definitely some bottom notes inside that chop. When I say bottom notes, I mean subtones, that if we EQ out everything, we could get those subtones. Or do I just want to play something on top? It'll be quicker if I just play something on top. I'm just thinking, what can I play? Like what, VST or 808? I got the notes for this portion of the beat. I'll play it out. Try to catch it in this section right now. Section. Mm-hmm. So we got three sections of the sample chopped up, the same drums pretty much predominantly through the whole track, and different sections of the subtone, the sub 808. I might still go back inside the sample and EQ out the highs and push up the lows of the inside the sample, come up with, see how those subtones sound, and then replay the sub 808s. But right now, it sound funky to me. How it sound to you? Let me know down in the comments. You heard? Drums knock, you know what I'm saying? All those drums came out of Inferno Drums, soundoracle.net. Go pick them up. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if the Inferno Drums is going to be there anymore because, again, I believe Sound Oracle was running a sale. But, yo, good looking, my man. Drums knock, heavy. So as a recap real quick for this episode of Sample School Sundays, we found it, the sample, we chopped up the sample, we tuned the sample, we pitched the sample, we changed the BPM. We also found the BPM of the sample originally because, you know, we have to find the sample's BPM before we make any adjustments. So we chopped up the sample. And then we played some drums underneath the sample. And then we played some sub-tone 808 kicks on underneath the drums and made it knock even more heavier. I'm not sure how it's sounding out there for you guys, but I'm currently in the red. I'm in the red, so I know I'm gonna have to do some mixing. You know, like I say all the time, Ancient Kemet was not built in a day, so I'm not gonna rush greatness or potential greatness, as I like to say. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to chop down some more, find some more chops in the beat, and put it all together, cook it up, and make it rock. But we have reached the limitations and it is my time. So I like to start off by thanking you for making it this far in the episode. And if you made it this far in the episode and you're not subscribed, do subscribe now. If you made it this far in the episode and you are subscribed and you have not hit the Liberty Bell, hit the Liberty Bell now. If you are subscribed, thank you for your support for all this time. You know, I appreciate it. I appreciate it for real. And that's pretty much it, man. I am BK, BKBangers.com. Welcome to another episode of Sample School Sundays. Thank you so much for your time. Peace, love, and life. Till next time. And do remember, y'all, music is life. It is your DNA. Keep banging. Peace. We'll be right back. All right, y'all. Peace.